Antichrist coming, Sananda, adopts the name Jesus Christ, adopts the name Emmanuel. And that's what demons will do. Demons will adopt the names of biblical figures to mimic them, to mock them. And we're not going to see anything different in the last days. And I've got pictures of this Sananda on my website, and he looks exactly like the Jesus Christ of the Bible that we've been shown pictures of since Michelangelo painted a portrait of Sananda back in the 1400s. And since then, the church has adopted that portrait of Sananda as being one of Jesus Christ. And so all these people, they know, oh, that's not really what he looks like, but it's a picture we have of him. It's actually been this mental conditioning, because when Sananda comes looking exactly like him, they're going to accept him as the Messiah. There's going to be a lot of people fooled by it. A lot of people saying, oh, I saw that. That's the picture of Jesus. That's been hanging in my church for 30 years. And so that's why I've been reaching out to these churches, these pastors that are running these churches that have pictures of Sananda up in them, to take them down, take them off. The Jesus Christ, the Yeshua, that died on the cross for our sins, was not a long-haired blonde or lightly brown hair. Sananda is. And that's why he wants everyone to believe that Jesus Christ is. Even a lightly light brown hair. I mean, it doesn't fit the mold at all of anyone who lived in the Middle East during the time of the Lord's birth, life, and death. At that time, of any of the people that lived there besides the Gentile races, besides maybe the Romans. You know, there was no Hebrew that had, you know. And I know that I'm going to get a lot of emails after this show in regards to this. But that's just, you know, the Ascended Masters, if you've seen the New Age theology, and the freaks coming claiming that they're our creators and that they're our messiahs and they're our gods, they're angels, they're fallen angels, and angels are blonde-headed and blue-eyed. And so they do have to do something to cover up the way they look. And that's why, you know, I don't even get into looks too much on the show, because if you do, they'll just find a way to mimic it. They'll find a way to counter it. And they already did with Maitreya. They have him looking Arab. But so far, the Sananda that's coming, the one playing Jesus in the astral realm, that covers near-death experiences, the realm of near-deaths, where people have died, thought they went to heaven and saw Jesus, and they've all ran into this Sananda. You know, that's the guy that's coming. That's why it's going to be so deceptive when people see him, and they're going to point to him and say, oh, that's Jesus. That is Jesus. You know, and they're going to be accepting him. A couple of questions, comments from listeners. Can you talk about the Book of Enoch? This was discussed on the History Channel last night. This book was banned from the Bible. Yeah, it was. No, it was banned from the Bible. It was taken out. Just as a lot of books were. Make room for Paul. Take out the real books. Enoch, folks, you got to be careful, because they do have an Enochian language. It's a satanic language that they perverted, that a lot of these tongue speakers will use and not realize they're using or praying in. And it's this Enochian language. And they also have their own take, their own books and stuff on the keys of Enoch. And if you follow these family lines of Seth and Cain, Cain had a son named Enoch, just as Seth did. And so there are two different Enochs out there. And the Enoch that the Illuminati just rules over is the one that was the grandson of Cain. And he goes through that line. And what he does is he perverts the real Enoch. He perverts, because the real Enoch is a patriarch of our faith. It is, you know, Noah's grandfather, which means if you wanted to throw out Enoch, some people say, well, he's not of the Lord, he wasn't God. He's a pillar of who we are as an Israelite race, as a Christian faith, because, you know, Noah came from him. All of us basically did, because Enoch was only a couple down from Seth. And so you look at Abraham and Jacob and the 12 different tribes and all the different races of people that are attributed to Abraham, everybody eventually leading back to Enoch, because if we're all from Adam, And some people say, well, you know, even Noah, you want to say, well, no, we came from Noah's four sons. Well, there you go. I mean, they don't go any further. They go just as far back to Enoch. And so what they do is they've perverted a lot of teachings from Enoch. But I'm getting off trail here, because the reason it was banned from the Bible itself, the book of Enoch, the patriarch Enoch, is because it had a lot of truths in it that they wanted to hide. I mean, if you look at my website and all of my articles about the beginning of time, about the coming UFO alien invasion, everything that I teach quotes Enoch. Not everything. But a lot of the stuff that I teach, especially when it comes to the Anunnaki and the aliens and what we're experiencing in these last days, as in the days of Noah, you will find in the book of Enoch, chapter 10, where he describes who these angels, these fallen watchers, these watchers that fell and procreated with human women.
You have a caller?
Yeah. Okay, go ahead and put them on.
You're up, caller.
Hello, Shay.
Yeah.
This is Paul from Sugar Grove, Pennsylvania.
Hey, how you doing?
Well, pretty good. I'm just a little confused. I haven't watched Pat Robertson or Kenneth Copeland, Paul and Jan Crouch, Benny Hinn, or Billy Graham. What is the story on them?
Well, they're all part. They're all interconnected. If you look into their histories, they're Masons.
I wouldn't doubt it.
They're fine that they're Masons and they're Knight of Malta. They're Jesuits. They all lead back to occult secret societies of the Vatican itself, posing as Protestant ministers. And so whenever you're involved with a secret society like the Knights of Malta or the Jesuits or the Masons, they all pledge oaths of loyalty to Lucifer.
So what are they doing that's wrong? Like I said, I haven't been watching them.
They teach about 80% truth, and they throw in rat poison. And the rat poison is what's getting everybody, because obviously they have to teach, you know, truth and correct things, or people would easily discover them as wolves and throw them out and spit them out. They're being deceived in a lot of doctrines that put them to sleep. Like you listen to Jack Van Impe, you're sure a rapture is going to come tomorrow and whisk you away from everything bad that's coming. You buy my book. The rapture's in 87, the rapture's in 97, 2007. Keep changing the dates, keep making millions and having people buy your book.
For decades.
They commercialize the Lord.
Yeah. Buy my tapes.
Yeah, they teach doctrines of devils.
They're going to
be the ones, but look at Pat Robertson. I mean, he's the one promoting this Verichip. Yeah, he promotes
Pat
it.
Robertson?
Yeah,
the
digital angel.
Wow.
And so when it comes down to it, when this Sananda is roaming the earth as God, and you've got Pat Robertson and the whole TBN crew pounding on the gavels that this is the Messiah we waited for, we just screwed up our theology. There's no end-day prophecies like we taught. This is the Messiah. Yes, get his mark of loyalty on your hand and forehead. A lot of people are going to fall for it.
What's going on with Paul Crouch? Is he sick or?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I have no idea. I don't watch it.
Well, okay.
It's been a while since I've seen it.
I heard he has cancer.
He probably has AIDS. I mean, I posted a code years ago that he was a homosexual. And I got an email about 6 months ago saying how right on I was and all the stuff about from a listener about Paul Crouch. He may be suffering from it.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Thank you.
All right, thanks for calling in.
Bye.
Bye-bye. That's going to wrap up the first hour, folks. We'll be back in about 5 minutes, begin the second half of the show. We'll see you then in about 5 minutes. Right.